So what is the third character option we have? That is B or M. Either third character might be capital B or capital M. For that, you need to open same square bracket. You need to open same square bracket. Write down capital B without comma, without space, without any other character. Simply write down capital M and close the bracket. And close the bracket. Okay. This means this particular pattern will allow whatever I have written, whatever I have written until now, this pattern will allow a string which is consisting of the first letter as 2, second letter as 0, and third letter as either B or M. Either B or M. That means 20B it will allow. 20M it will allow. If you enter 20A, it will not allow. If you enter 20 some C, it will not allow. It will allow only two strings, those are 20B and 20M. So let us go with fourth option. What is the fourth letter? The fourth letter is C. It is fixed. It is fixed. So for that, open square bracket, write down that C and close that square bracket. That means the fourth letter must be C. Next. What is the fifth letter? Again, fifth letter is also having two options, two letters. It might be O, it might be O, so write down O. Or it might be E, so write down E and close the square bracket. So let me reduce this font size so that it will be in one line. Done? Okay. So now the fourth letter, sorry, the fifth letter, either it might be O or E. It will allow only O or E. So next. What is the next letter? Next letter is 0. In both the cases, next letter is 0. 0. And next letter is also 0. Next letter is also a 0. And what is the third last letter? 2 or 3. So if I use this pattern, the Google form will allow only two numbers. Those are this first one and second one. Once you done this, you just copy and paste. You just copy, Control C, I am copying it. Copy it and go to Google Forms. Here in the pattern, you just paste it. So in the custom error text, please give proper ID. So I am making it as a required. Now let me go back to this preview option. I am going with the preview option. So the name of the student, Purna. And next mobile number, I have to enter exact 10 digit. 3393994. Next roll number. Here the roll number must be the same pattern. What is that pattern? This one, 20BC. I will enter random number. Whether it is allowing or not, we will see. So I have entered some random number. So see what is asking. It is not allowing me to submit the form. It is showing the error message like please give proper ID. So then he has to enter his exact ID, proper ID. What is that ID? 20 MCE 003. Now I click submit. It is allowing because it is valid. It is valid rule number. So let me go with other 957-339-3994. I have to enter 10 digit. That is the reason I am given complete mobile number. Otherwise it will give error message. So rule number again 20. I will go with the next pattern BC O002. Submit. So now it is allowing. Now it is taking the response. But here what I have considered only two numbers. But you will be having 002, 003, in some cases 010 also, 0A2 also. So let me know from that particular madam who has given this pattern. Madam, can you unmute yourself once again?
Yes, sir. Can you hear me, sir?
Yes, ma'am. Madam, what is the What is the maximum number? What is the last student number in this particular pattern? 20 BC.
Up to 120, sir. 120.
Okay. 20 BC. O.
120. The last three digits.
Okay. O. 120.
Zero.
Okay. 120. So now, please give a second. Phone is coming. Hello. Meeting lo unnanu tarvata. So now I want the student to enter this particular range of ID rule number. So that means my regular expression must allow 20 BC 0 to 120. So that means it must allow 003 also. It must allow 040 some kind of number. For that, the small change is here. Previously I used only 0. Now I have to use 0 to 9. So that means that character might be 0 or 1 or 2 or 3 or anything. Because your pattern is consisting of only maximum of 1, you can write down 0, 1 also. 0, 1 also. But in some cases, it may go to 220, 320, 420, 450, 920. So the part that is the reason I am using 0 to 9. 0 to 9. The next digit also may consisting of not only 0, it may consisting of 0, 1 or anything. I mean any digit. For that reason I am using 0 to 9. Similarly for the last character also you can use 0 to 9. So now you can enter any number. That means the student can enter any number which is following the pattern like 20 BC 0 to 999. So this particular pattern will allow this range of numbers. I will give the range 0 20 MCE 999. So these ranges are covered by this particular pattern. Did you get the point why I am changing to 0 to 9? Hello.
Yes, sir.
Yes. So now here one small change is there.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Now here one small change is there. That is like it is optional, but it is good. The thing is here, if you look at all this pattern, the first letter 2 is static. The first letter 2 is static. Static means fixed. This first letter is not changing. All over this range of rule numbers, the very first letter is 2 only. So for that reason, you can remove this square bracket. You have to remove the square bracket which is fixed, which is static. Okay. Next letter is O. Sorry, next letter is 0. For the entire range of rule numbers, for which you are applying this response validation, the second letter is 0. That is fixed. So whenever it is fixed, you can remove that square bracket. But the next letter is, it might be B or M. So you cannot remove this square bracket for this B and M. B or M. Let it be. Next one is C. Fourth character is C. So you have to keep it. You can remove this square bracket because it is fixed. And next one is again OE. OE is, it is not fixed. So that is the reason I am not removing this square bracket. Again, this 0 to 9 is not fixed. 0 to 9 is not fixed. 0 to 9 is not fixed. So whichever character is fixed, whichever character is static, for that particular character, you need not to put that square bracket. If you put the square bracket, that is also good. Okay. So this is what regular expression for any kind of set of rule numbers. So I am going to apply this one. Copy and paste here. So now the time is 11:50. I will explain two more questions. Then I will take all the doubts in the comment section. Because so many doubts are there, I will go with that. Okay. So let me complete this. Control V. So response validation is added. So now next question. Date of birth. Next question is date of birth. So when I written DOB, automatically it is changed to date. If it is not changed, you can select the date. So this is the importance of date. So this is the pattern, month, day, year. It is automatically detected. You need not to worry about the pattern. You need not to worry about the pattern. You will see that preview. You will see the preview option. Now I am making required. Now I am making required. So let me go to preview. Let me go to preview. Name of the student. I have given name of the student and mobile number 9573939994. Now roll number. Roll number must be the same pattern. 20. What is that? 20 M. C E.
Hello.
M C E.
Sorry, sir. Excuse me, sir.
Yes, yes.
Sir, your screen is not visible, sir.
Oh, screen got small, put na.
Small screen, sir.
Network issue, sir. It is always it is resuming, stopping and resuming. Please. Now it is okay, sir. Now it is presenting.
Yes, sir. Okay, it is clear. Okay.
So now roll number I have given 20 MCE 992. See, 992 will be there in the range. In our range, okay, it will accept. So now you can look at this DOB option. So here, with the help of this DOB field, this date field, you will be getting unique date, because every student has to use this option only. He has to click this calendar option. So you need to select that his date and month and year, so that we will get a unique answer for DOB. Then click submit, it will be taken. Okay, so this is what. One more question type, that is DOB, and one more option. Let me add multiple choice. I am taking my scenario. Let us say I want to ask class, because I belong to ECE, we have second year, third year, final year, and in each year we have three sections. For that reason, I want to ask class as 2 ECE, secondary ECE, third ECE, and fourth ECE. I am not adding sections 2 ECE A, 2 ECE B, 2 ECE C. That is also possible. But for the example, I am showing, for the demonstration purpose, I am showing class, that is 2 ECE, or the student belongs to third ECE or fourth ECE. So I am making it as a required. So let me go back to preview. Student name 9573939994 and roll number 20MCE999. Some date of birth I've selected. So class. This is the MCQ. You cannot select two options at a time. You can select only one. See, if I select one, other automatically disabled. So I belongs to third ECE. Submit. It is submitted. Okay. So as of now, under questions, we added short answer questions. Obviously, short answer means paragraph is also similar to that. And we used MCQ. Here, instead of MCQ, you can use this choice drop down also. Instead of MCQ, you can use drop down also. Okay. And we have seen the how to add date. You try out the remaining questions. That is what your first assignment. You have to prepare your first Google form with whatever the possible question types. And you please try these first options, first question types. Try to include short answer, try to include paragraph, multiple choice, checkboxes, drop down, file upload. Let me give one example file upload. Plus, with this, I will stop this session now, and I will take your doubts. So after this, I will end that. So the question is like, please upload recent passport size photo. Please upload recent passport size photo. Your recent passport size photo. So it is not changed. So now you select this file upload. The moment when you click this file upload button, it is asking you permission. That means it is informing you whatever the data is going to be uploaded by the users of that particular Google form, that will be loaded, that will be saved into your drive, whether you want to allow or not, whether you want to continue or not, that kind of information will come. So let me click on continue. I want, okay, no problem, continue. So now you will be getting some more fields in this particular question. Those are allow only specific type files, allow only specific file types. Exactly. I want to get a photo from the student. I don't want any document or any video. So for that reason, you have to click this option. The moment when you click this option, you will be getting different types of files which you are expecting from the student. So what I am expecting? I am expecting not audio. I am not expecting video. I am expecting image. So click on that image. So that means it will allow, this corresponding question will allow only emojis. Will allow only images to upload. And you can give the maximum number of files. That means whether he can upload only one file. I mean whether he has to enter only one image, or whether you want to up to five images, that means you can enter one image or two image or three image or four image or five image. But for this question, for our scenario, we need only one image. Next option is maximum file size. So what are the sizes are available? 1 MB, 10 MB, 100 MB, 1 GB, 10 GB. But for general image, passport size, 1 MB is enough. 1 MB is enough. 1 MB is enough. But based on your situation, based on your requirement, this option will change. This size option will change. So with these settings, what you are doing, what you are allowing? You are allowing the student to enter, to upload his photo, his recent passport size photo, which is 1 MB, less than 1 MB, which is less than 1 MB. And he can upload only one image. He can upload only one image. Okay, but based on your requirement, you can change the number of files and you can change the size also. Okay, so this is what first Google form. If you go to preview form, again you will be getting your preview. I will explain one option, send, but we have more options, the settings option, this theme option, and one more option. So many options are there. We need to look into responses also. What are the responses? How to get these responses into spreadsheet? That we will see. Okay. But as of now, the assignment for you is you need to go through that URL and you need to create your first Google form with different types of questions. And after that, you need to share that link in the group, in the WhatsApp group. Now the question arises, how to get the link. For that, simply go to send, top right side, you will be getting you will be seeing a icon called send with blue color. Okay, so click on that send. Under send, you have three kind of options. One is send via mail, and one is get the link, and another is embed. This embed option we will be seeing, this is what some advanced, but we will be using only this link option or mail option. Link option or mail option. So go with this link. Just you can copy this link or you can shorten this. Shorten means whatever the lengthy URL is there, that will be reduced. You just copy that. Okay. So now this copied URL you need to submit or you need to post in WhatsApp group. Okay, if you have any kind of doubts how to post in WhatsApp group, I will share one video. You please watch it. Okay. So this is what your assignment. So now let me take your doubts from the comment session. Can we have the range for alphabets like we used it in numbers? Yes, sir. I will give one example in comment section. Please, all of you look into that comment section. So our question is, can we have the range? For that, I am giving one more example, sir. You please look at this, our Google form. Let me check preview. Sir, what is the question we are asking? Name of the student. The very first question is name of the student. And what description we have given? Please enter your name in block letters and as per SSC memo. Okay. We have given only description for this question. We didn't added any response validation. That means it cannot detect what user is entering. So let me enter like this. Purna. Even though I have seen the description, that question is asking us to enter only capital letters. But I have entered small letters. So let me check whether it is allowing or not. It will allow because we didn't added any response validation. It will allow. Please bear with me. I will give example. 20MCE003 and date of birth, some number I am giving, and class. See, this is a drop down. Just I change the question type. So card DCE. I want to upload this one. I made mandatory. Want to upload image. I upload one image. Uploaded. Upload option. So it is uploaded. Whatever you are seeing, this is for user end. This is for student end. Okay. Submit. Click submit. It is submitted. That means it is not checking. It is not validating what the name is, whether the entered name in block letter or not. It is not verifying. Let me give example of response validation. Response validation. How I am going? See, going three dots, clicking response validation. More fields are added. Under this, I am going to use regular expression and matches. Regular expression matches. Now I will use that pattern. What is that pattern? This is related to your doubt, sir. What is the doubt? Can we have the range of alphabets like we used it in numbers? This is in rule number section. I got it, sir. There also you can use. But as of now, we'll go with this, sir. What we are asking the student to enter? The student has to enter only capital letters. And what is the size of that string? We don't know. We cannot predict the size of the maximum size of the any name, any person name. Okay? It might be 100 characters also. Some names will be 100 characters from South Africa. So we don't know the length of the character, length of the name. But we know screen is not visible. You are presenting. Sir, I am presenting only, sir. I am in in comment section only. Just wait. I am presenting. Don't worry. And now are you able to see, sir? Can you unmute yourself? Are you able to see Word document?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So please. Now I want a regular expression. Which allows only capital letters. For that, the regular expression is like this. Open square bracket, capital A to Z. So I am considering entire English alphabet with capital letters. You can write down A, B, C, D, E, F, G up to Z also. But no need to write because it is in the sequence, you can write down A dash Z. Okay, I am allowing a capital letters, whether it is A or up to Z. And what is the size? Generally, if you know the size, if you can predict the size, if you want to restrict the size, you have to use this flower bracket and you need to write down 12 characters or 13 characters or 11 characters. But in this case, we don't know the size of the user, the name of the user. Okay, for that reason, you have to use a star. You need to use a star option here. This particular regular expression will allow only capital letters. Will allow a string of only capital letters. And it will not allow any spaces also. Let me give example. Control C. I am copying that regular expression. I am pasting here. Okay. And remaining I am not making required because for our demonstration purpose it is taking time. That is the reason I am removing this required option so that I can skip those questions. Directly we can check that only name of the student. I hope everyone got this point. Why I am removing this required option? For our demonstration purpose only I am removing. Okay. So I am going with preview. Let me check whether I added or not. I added. Okay. So I am going with preview. Name of the student. Let me write down small letter P. I am writing my name in small letters Purna. So all are not required now. You need not to answer them. Directly I am clicking submit. I am clicking submit. See what it is asking. Must match pattern. Because we didn't customize our message. It is showing default message. That is must match pattern. Okay. So now if I enter capital P or capital letters, it will allow. If I enter capital letters, it will allow. Because we have given a regular pattern, regular expression pattern, which is allowing only capital letters. Let me write down custom error text. Please enter capital letters only. Okay. So let me go back to again preview. This time let me write down my complete name capital in capital letters. Please all of you observe my name. My name is Purna Chandar Reddy. In between Purna and Chandar a space is there. In between Chandar and Reddy a space is there. But our regular expression is checking only whether the given string is consisting of capital letters or not. It is not going to check the spaces. That means if you are going to submit this form with this particular answer, it will not allow. Submit. What is the error showing? Please enter capital letters only. But okay, even though you entered capital letters, it is not allowing. The reason is we are not included the space option. That means whatever the your regular expression, that must allow capital letters as well as space also, because you will get spaces in between the name. For that purpose, you need to add extra character in that particular set, that is backslash s. Now this particular pattern will allow any string which is consisting of only capital letters and as well as spaces. Let me check whether it is allowing now. I will copy and paste. Okay, now I updated. Let me go with preview. Now I will write down my complete name, Purna Chandar Reddy. So now my name consisting of capital letters and as well as some spaces also there, white spaces. So now it is allow. Now it is allowing. The reason is we included that space validation also, the space validation, white space validation also in that regular pattern, in that regular expression pattern. So let me go with other doubts. So now the time is 12:06. So officially this session is completed. The remaining we will see in the next session. As of now, if you have any doubts, you can be in online and you can ask.
Sir Purna sir.
Ah sir.
Sir, can you please explain once again how to share this link?
How to save and share this link? Okay, right done sir. So because I need to explain that send option more detail in the next session, but okay, I will cover now. Sir, are you able to see my screen? Now I am in Google page only.
Yes.
Let me open WhatsApp web. So all of you using this WhatsApp web, same WhatsApp app in web version. Okay. The assignment is you have to prepare your first Google form, particularly student personal information. You include all question types. After preparing your Google form, go to send option, which is available top right side. Click on send. Under send, you have three kind of options. The very first one is you can share the link to your student. If you have your student mail IDs. Okay. Otherwise, you can copy the link. Where is that option? Second option. The link option is there. I will zoom in. See, the very first one is Gmail icon option, that is to mail your link to your students. Or the second option is link. To get the link, you click on the second option. So now I am copying this. How to copy this? After clicking this, sir, here downside copy option is there. Are you able to see, Krishna sir?
Yes.
If you click this copy, that means your link is copied to clipboard. Your link is copied to clipboard. You have in that you have this link in background. You can paste everywhere.
Okay.
So now go to.
Okay.
Now go to your WhatsApp. This is one kind of way. Other way also I will share in group. Go to explore Google Forms. Then you paste there, and by mentioning your name, like this. I forgot. Just this is my first form. Okay. Then
okay.
Paste it and send. Like this, everyone has to create their own first form. They need to send here so that other will go through that form. They will fill that. So that we will come to know what are the mistakes and learning by mistakes will happen. Okay. So this is what.
Okay. Thank you, Purna. Thank you, Purna sir.
We are going to discuss more in detail about this send option. How it will looks if I send via Gmail. How it looks. You will be seeing. Okay. You will be seeing. Don't worry. As of now, for assignment purpose, I explained how to copy. Okay. Let me take other doubts. Sir, as of now, this regular, whatever official session is completed. Okay. If you are free, you can be in online. Please go ahead with your doubts. I am ready to what for star. Padmanabhan sir. Okay. Sir, can you unmute yourself? Padmanabhan sir, Professor Padmanabhan sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir. What's your doubt, sir? What is the purpose of star after A to Z, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, sir. Sir, if you are putting only A to Z character, A to Z square bracket option pattern.
Okay.
Let me write down in the comment box, sir. A to Z, this one. Are you able to see in comment section, sir? What I have typed? A to Z.
Yes, sir.
If you are using only A to Z, this particular pattern in your Google form. See, I am writing that. I am removing star. I am removing that white space character. Okay. So now I am going with preview button. Let me write down the name, sir. PORNA. Okay. PORNA. Let me click submit. It is giving error, sir. What is that error? This is customized error, sir. You please don't worry. This is customized error. But the intention is it is not allowing multiple characters. It is not allowing multiple characters. Let me reduce one character. I am removing A. Only I have written Purna. Let me click submit. Again, it is not allowing. Okay. I will remove entire letters. I will keep only P. Only one letter. Click submit. It is accepting. That means this particular pattern, A to Z pattern, will allow only one character. This particular pattern A to Z will allow only one character. It might be P, A, Z, anything. Only one character it will allow. But the name consisting of multiple characters. The name is nothing but collection of characters. So that means it is multiple. So for that reason, you are putting a star because you don't know the size. I am putting a star. If you know the size of the string, you have to use flower bracket. If you know the size of the string as maximum as 12, you can write down the 12. Okay. Otherwise, sir. Otherwise, you can put star mark. Sir, whatever the doubts I am explaining, if you still have any doubts, we have one-to-one communication also. One-to-one communication with the help of TeamViewer. Okay. That is there. With the help of that also, we can again connect. Okay. There is no hesitation. Please ask her if you have any doubts. Next doubts.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir, for your kind doubt. Next, Kavita madam. Kavita madam, can you unmute yourself? Let me know what is your exact doubt. Name with initials. That means you want to allow
sir, that. Name with initials, but the initials to be done at the end, sir. Shall we give any specifications?
Initial, then you can use the different fields like first name and last name.
First name and last name. Okay, so salutation, including salutations and all.
That also you can. Then you need to work out with regular expression more in deep. Like regular expression will be increased.
That
will be done, madam. That you can done, that you can do. You can allow only the students to enter Mr. Capital M, small
R, yes, sir.
If other than if you are writing anything, it will not allow. That is also possible.
Yes, sir.
Let me write down that expression in comment box, madam. Or I will write down in Word. You please look at this. I want first character must be M. Okay. And second character must be, because we have boys and girls, so R, S. And third character must be dot. Third character must be a dot. And next characters might be anything. Next characters might be anything which consisting of space also. And the size also, I don't know. It can be any size. Or you can give maximum size also. So let me minimize. Reduce the size. Madam, this pattern will allow the first letter M. If you are entering the first letter other than M, it will not allow. The second letter, either it might be R or S. That means Mr. or Miss. Dot. The third letter must be dot. Okay? But generally,
yes, sir.
But generally, for this, we have simple solution, madam. Instead of asking the entire name in one question, you put a salutation question, separate question.
Separate name as separate and salutation as separate.
Then that is good. That is good. Because do you remember, madam, our general registration form, like webinar registration form?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
In that, I asked different questions for this kind of full name, right?
Yes, sir.
That is possible. Whenever it is not possible with all basic features of Google form, basic things, then you go to this regular expression.
Okay, sir. Okay, sir.
Okay. Next.
Okay.
Thank you. Thank you so much, madam. Next.
Thank you.
Shanti, I generate and send you to, sir. I am beginner. It takes some time. Sure, sir. That is the reason I will be available for one-to-one communication, sir. Here, sometimes I am going fast because already few participants are familiar with Google Form. They are asking somewhat advanced doubts. That is the reason you are not unable to understand. But please ping me personally. One-to-one communication is there. I can explain within 5 minutes because it is one-to-one communication. Next question, please, because I cannot scroll up again. Any question is there, you just put in comment box. We'll go with doubts.
Sir?
Yes,
Saranya, ma'am. Sir?
Yeah, go ahead, ma'am.
Sir, when I tried with the register numbers,
yes,
I just made an attempt like the first 5 digits are static and the last 3 digits are changing.
Okay, done. What is the regular expression you have written?
So when I wrote it as 20MBM as static. Okay. So I didn't give square bracket, nothing.
Just
so
it is 20M. 20M next.
BM.
BM.
20MBM.
20MBM, right. Next.
And the last 3 digits. Yes, sir.
Zero
last 3 digits I gave it as square bracket.
Just look at comment section, madam. This is what you are trying to say. 20MBM 029 029 029.
Yes, sir.
What is the error you are getting?
Sir, I gave this.
Hmm.
Yes, sir, I gave this, but when I tried the preview and when I entered the number, it says it must match pattern.
What number you have given?
I gave 20MBM 005. When I gave that number in the preview document, just to ensure whether this is correct.
I got it. It is not allowing, right?
Yes, sir, it's not allowing, sir.
Are you using laptop, madam? Are you using laptop? Can you share?
Sir, as of now, I just logged out. Logged out, sir.
Okay. No issue. I think small mistake will be there, but this particular pattern, what you have written, it has to allow the numbers like 20MBM 0002, 20MBM 999. Madam, after this session, one-to-one communication, we will see, madam, because with the help of TeamViewer, I can control your screen so that I can know what exactly you have done. Okay.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, madam. Next, any doubts? Because we have 20 participants in the online. As of now, just we covered only how to create Google form and how to send it in WhatsApp group, how to add few type of questions and regular expressions. If you have any doubts in regular expression as of now, please put in comment section. 20 people are there. Padmanabhan sir, do you have any doubts?
No sir, it is clear.
Okay sir, now you can leave the group sir. You can leave from meeting because it is actually completed, because without wasting time, because it is going to lunch time. Next Kavita. Okay. Madam. Kavita madam. Madam, do you have
yes,
any
sir, yes sir.
Do you have
no,
any
sir,
doubts as of now?
We will prepare the assignment and we will send to you sir.
Okay madam.
Thank you so much sir. Thank you.
Sir, I am not in WhatsApp group. Can I join now sir? 9573993994. Just ping to this number madam. Just ping to this number, WhatsApp number. I will add you. Okay. Next, who is there? Next, Swapna madam, can you unmute yourself? As of now, we covered only basics, madam, and not completely. Just we have seen few basics. Tomorrow, we are going to see more options. Arun sir, are you there?
Hi, sir.
Sir, as of now, we covered only basics. Do you have any doubts as of now?
No, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. The official session is completed. You can go for lunch, sir.
Okay, sir. Thank you.
In the afternoon time, if you have any doubts, you personally just ping me, sir.
Definitely, sir.
We will have one-to-one communication. Next.
Okay, sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Next, Professor Suma, madam. Madam, are you there? Next, Shivaraju sir. Next, who else? Paramesh sir, are you there? Next, Nadan sir. Suma madam, if you have any doubts, you can unmute madam. You can unmute yourself. Otherwise, you can go for lunch. Having some audibility issue. Okay, madam. We can have one-to-one communication, madam, for doubts clarification. Thank you so much, madam. Next, Nadan sir. I think next, Paramesh sir. Okay, no issue. Loknath sir, shall we close? Shall we stop?
Okay.
Thank you.